awake and alive. And all my instincts, they return. And the grand facade, it will burn. Without a noise, without my pride, I reach out from the inside. In your eyes, the light, the heat, I feel complete.
Your eyes,
I see the doorway of a thousand churches.
Your eyes,
the resolution of all my fruitless searches. Oh, I see the light and the heat. The light, the heat, your eyes, I feel complete.
Your eyes,
I see the doorway of a thousand churches.
Your eyes,
realization of all my fruitless searches. Oh, I see the light and the heat. Oh, I want to be that complete. I want to touch the light, the heat I see in your eyes. In your eyes.
Here we go again.
In your eyes.
Look at this. Welcome, everybody. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, I guess I'm going to use this because we forgot about the headset.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Wow. I don't know if I'm going to be able to keep a dry eye. I'm so glad that Rev Mo came in between me and Reverend Stacy's love letter because we needed a moment of not crying. But at least, Unity, we don't mind tears. I'm so grateful to be here. Welcome. Welcome, everyone, to our slice of heaven. It really, truly, truly is. And you know that we believe here at Unity that there is only one power and one presence, and it is active in the universe, and it shows up as every one of us in this room. And so we are grateful for this time together. And I just want to take a moment to let us say hello to one another. If you don't know the person sitting next to you, introduce yourself. Say hello. And I'll say hello to those that are going to watch us later online. Thank you for being here. We know that you are here by divine appointment. Celebration, celebration. Oh my goodness. 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 Okay. Sorry. So the first song we're going to sing, you're going to indulge me, is a really special song to me because it's how I feel about you all. And my mom used to sing it to me when she was around. And we have never done it, but it's a Carpenter song, and you all know it, so stand and sing it with us. I get to be over here.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. And the reason is clear, it's because you are here. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I've seen. I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. Something in the wind has learned my name, and it's telling me that things are not the same. In the leaves of the trees and the touch of the breeze, there's a pleasing sense of happiness for me. There is only one wish on my mind. When this day is through, I hope that I will find that tomorrow will be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are here. I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Let's do that again.
I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
And that's the truth. Thank you very much. The job is over today. So now we're just going to settle in for a second, and you're going to join me in an opening prayer. Woo. Just feel all that amazing love energy in this room. Isn't it amazing? I just want us to turn within and allow that presence to just permeate every cell in our body. Let's take a deep breath collectively together in gratitude for the time we get to spend together right here. Oh, beloved, I am presence. We're so grateful to be filled to overflowing with this inexhaustible energy, with this indestructible health, with inescapable abundance and joy, and irresistible divine love that we are. We are so grateful for all that is ours, all the gifts, all the blessings. And we thank you for this day and this message and this incredible music team and all that needs to be shared today fills every single heart and soul in this room. We know this to be true. We thank you for the fellowship and the love and the amazing bond of this heaven on earth we call Unity of the Oaks. Thank you, everyone, for being here. Thank you for your presence and for blessing this space. We are so grateful. And so it is.
I'm here to remind you of your magnificence, to help you awake to all the wonder that you are. I long to show you all the joy you're worthy of. I'm here to remind you how much you're truly loved. I'm here to remind you of your magnificence, to help you awake to all the wonders that you are. I long to show you all the joy you're worthy of. I'm here to remind you how much truly love. Ooh.
much your love.
Good morning, beautiful Unity of the Oaks. How soon we forget. I'm Janie, one of the members of the prayer team, and I will be available to pray with you after service in the little room right around the corner. I'll be mingling with most of you, so just tap me on the shoulder. Don't expect me to wait for you in there. I'll just be roaming, and just let me know. There should be a little note on the door if you want to put your name on it. I'll come looking for you. So, thanks. Our word for today is leadership. I lead with courage and wisdom. I can be a leader no matter my age or where I am in my life's journey. As a parent, teacher, business person, or student, I make the most of opportunities to be a trailblazer and to demonstrate to others how to live and give with my whole heart. Leadership is both inherent and learned. Through my natural ability to make wise decisions, I positively direct my life and seek to inspire others. Learning from my experiences, I discern even better ways to lead. The same qualities within me are within all people. I bless the world's leaders and envision each one living a life of wisdom, peace, and service. I affirm divine order in all that they do and in each life they serve. And from Luke, the greatest among you must become as the youngest, and the leader like the one who serves. Again, the word for today is leadership, and the affirmation, I lead with courage and wisdom. And so it is. Amen.
Thank you, Janie. So it's our time for meditation. We're just going to take a moment to settle into our chairs and feel comfortable. Maybe rest your hands and close your eyes. We are in the Lenten season right now, and we haven't had a chance to talk about that much, but our co-founder, Charles Fillmore, suggested that we let go of negative thinking during Lent. So let's just take a moment to open our awareness and remember the truth of who we are, our magnificence, our beauty, our divine nature, the perfection of God made manifest right here and right now as each one of us. I let go, and I let divine life fulfill itself in and through me. My every need is fulfilled. I let go easily and effortlessly of any thought of worry, any thought of fear, or any judgment. I remove any and all blocks to my good right now. When limiting thoughts or problems or challenges arise, I make a conscious decision to let go and let God, to release any hold or attachment I have just by breathing out. I yield my limited thoughts to the divine within, remembering the limitless power of my true divine nature. I see myself in unity with divine life. Divine life lives in me and flows freely through my every cell. When I allow myself to simply let go, I live in the flow of divine life. I become open to the power of inspiration, insight, wisdom, and love. My mind is free. My mind is clear. My mind is renewed. Surrendering to the care and keeping of the divine within relieves me of anger, of worry, of anxiety. I relax into the flow and feel the presence of the divine and the wisdom of my inner guidance and intuition. I see new opportunities presenting themselves, synchronicities abounding, and that which seemed difficult or even impossible resolving effortlessly and smoothly. The divine in me is my path to freedom, abundance, peace, and harmony. I let go and let God manifest in my life with new adventures, unexpected pleasures, and unlimited potential. I am so grateful for this wisdom to let go and allow my highest good to unfold. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, sweet spirit, beloved presence. I am so grateful. When you're ready, just gently allow yourself to come back into the room, becoming aware of the beautiful presence next to you and the love that is right here. You can open your eyes when you're ready, and Rick will sing us another song. This one's for you, Revmo.
Moses had to put his foot in the water, foot in the water, foot in the water. Moses had to put his foot in the water before God would part that sea. Let's do it again. Moses had to put his foot in the water, foot in the water, foot in the water. Moses had to put his foot in the water before God would part that sea. Moses said, God, I hope you're listening, and in my heart you know you are. I'm sure you wouldn't leave us after bringing us this far. But man, I gotta tell you, Lord, things are looking mighty tense. I got Pharaoh and his boys behind me, and I don't see a hole in this fence. Oh, Moses had to put his foot in the water, foot in the water, foot in the water. Moses had to put his foot in the water before God would part that sea. Now then he said, Moses, you're full of greatness, and I've got big plans for you. But for now, I have to tell you, Mo, this is what I want you to do. You gotta raise your staff and tell everyone to get in to the swim. 'Cause if you want that sea to part, my boy, you're gonna have to get in. Oh, yeah. Moses had to put his foot in the water, foot in the water, foot in the water. Moses had to put his foot in the water before God would part that sea. Okay, now, Now I got daily seas to part, I got cliffs to climb. And he may not be where I expect him, but he always shows up on time. Break it down. Moses had to put his foot in the water, foot in the water, foot in the water. Moses had to put his foot in the water before to part that sea. Moses had to put his foot in the water, foot in the water, foot in the water. Moses had to put his foot in the water before God would part that sea. One more time. Moses had to put his foot in the water, foot in the water, foot in the water. Moses had to put his foot in the water before God would part that sea. What? I said before God would part that sea. What? Before God would part that sea. Here we go. And he always parts that sea. Ooh. And he does.
Wow, that's fun.
Wow. Well, that's a perk. Wow, you guys. Wow. Rick Kelling, you're just a fabulous MD, music director. Okay, so all I want to do right now, honestly, is give each and every one of you a hug. So I'm going to do a little experiment. Okay, I got to put this down. Well, you got to put one arm up here. I thought I was going to have the headset, but that's all right. Cross it over your left shoulder. Take your left arm, cross it over your right shoulder, and make a lot of noise. Okay. Oh, my goodness. I just want to say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you for allowing me, gifting me with the opportunity to swim in this water and to dive deep and to pull up those pearls for you and share them. Because I've been around Unity for a very long time. And there's a lot I'd like to share with you, so I'm glad you're going to be sticking around. Because I wrote about 5 talks for just today. But I realized that it was more about just telling you how much I love you and how much you've been there for me and how I wouldn't be standing here if it wasn't for all of you, honestly. This is why I am here. I am grateful. I feel very called to be here. I feel like this is mine to do, but it is only because of you. You were there to, in the last transition, when we had a hard time when RevMo retired, and we ended up having to go through a lot of different speakers and different people to come in, and I remember making a vow to myself right then and there that I was going to become credentialed in some way so that this community would always have someone at the helm if we needed it. I made that commitment back then, and I had just been taking spiritual education classes for fun at that point. But of course, Reverend Molly, otherwise known as RevMo, I didn't realize that you were the Moses in that story, but you are. And I'm standing right here with my staff. That's all I gotta say. Giving you the business, because she taught me how to do that. But she had actually kind of pushed me to take those classes for credit. And I thought, really? It's like $40. Do I need to do that? I mean, like, 30 classes later, we found ourselves in sort of a similar situation, but it ended up working okay, and I ended up calling Unity Worldwide and saying, what do I have to do next to become a licensed teacher? And Reverend Lynn Odell, who is the head of admissions, said, haven't you been there a long time? I said, almost 10 years, because this was almost 2 years ago. And she said, you know, you are eligible for the field ministry program. Have you ever thought about being a minister? I said, no. So she said, why don't you think about it? So I went in on my balcony on the house that I built to be close to you. And Spirit said, finally. And I felt like I was being given permission. It was like this, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, this is who I am. This is who I've always been. What? What? I didn't know that was supposed to look like that. And now, of course, all I could think of was, I have to be at a pulpit and speak? That's not who I am. Bada, bada, bada. And I thought, well, no, I have this entertainment industry business, and I can create content, and I can do all of it with my minister hat. So I moved slowly and gently into this leapfrog, which I'll talk to you about in a minute, because I wasn't ready to step into my zone of genius yet. I wasn't ready, but Spirit knew and designed it all just perfectly, as it is all designed for each one of us. And I don't even know where I was on any of this, but I am here. This community is how I began my ministerial journey. And that is the absolute truth. And this community and unity in the bigger picture has saved my life on more than one occasion. And I really felt it was important to share that with you. There's some things that I didn't share over here when I was wearing that hat. But since I have leapfrogged over here, I'm going to share them because I feel like I'm supposed to. Okay. This was the opportunity that Spirit had been preparing me for a while, because right after Rick found out that he was going to be leaving his tour with Kenny Loggins, and we thought, okay, how's our life going to look? I was happy about it, very happy, because I got to be home. We were going to get to work together. Spirit whispered something in my ear. Whispered, and I remember the moment. It was like, don't try to picture this. Let it flow. Things might appear differently than you think. Opportunities might show up in a different way. And I heard it loud and clear, and I thought, I wonder what that is. I had no idea. But I heard that Spirit, that voice first. And so when this happened, I was like, oh, this was the idea. And when I first got the call, believe me, I was like, what? You want me to maybe what? I got to think about this. So I did the same thing I did with Reverend Lynn. I went and sat down on my balcony, and I heard that. Well, finally, yes, step up. And I said, I know this is mine to do. If they want me, this is mine to do. And you wanted me, and you've always wanted me. And now I need to say, and you've always let me be my completely wackadoodle self, and loved me authentically, and empowered me to step into that zone of genius for so many years. Now I'm at 11. It's going to be 11 years I've been with you since, on March 17th was my first day, 2013, when I wore a big green bow and all green dress for Patty's Day, St. Patty's Day. But you, ever since, have always encouraged me to be my authentic self, no matter what was going on. And I've written songs. I've enjoyed every moment. Rick said, you didn't visualize this. And I said, no, I didn't really. But I intentionalized it from day one. Because once I walked in here and felt this, and I've been in many Unity churches, by the way. I was at Reverend Eric Butterworth's church in New York in Lincoln Center. This is really magical, what we have here. And we can never take it for granted, because it is powerful and palpable, and we are all healing each other, and we are growing because this collective consciousness provides enough love. We are perpetuating enough love for our yucky stuff to come up for us to heal. That's how it works. We think we've gotten to a point where we've grown and we've actually, you know, gotten out of an old habit or an old programming, and then suddenly it pops up again. Embrace it, because that means you've reached another level of love and trust and faith, that you've allowed that to come up for healing. That's all it means. Congratulations. Everything that we think of as a challenge is an opportunity. And the first thing everyone said to me was, thank you, but a lot of people said, are you up for the challenge? And I thought, let me think about that. Because I'd heard before that in Japanese, the word challenge means opportunity. So I looked that up in Wikipedia. And it did say that they changed the meaning of the original word of challenge to mean thriving, enduring, opportunity. The Japanese figured that out. And everything, there is an opportunity in every single thing, even when we can't see it, when it's hidden. We just need to know in the deepest part of us that the blessing is there, whether it's hidden or not. And one of the things that really blew me away was that we were at this teen retreat just a couple of weeks ago, and he's not here, I don't think, but if he is, he'd be very embarrassed. But I was really impressed with how brilliant our teens were. And one of them, Alex, we were talking about challenges, and he said, well, a challenge, I look at it as just a roadblock on the road. The road is an opportunity. And it's always there. It's just you might have a little roadblock from time to time. Well, that brought my life full circle. I just sat there going, oh, he got this at whatever, 14? And it reminded me, well, let me go back and share something. When I said Unity has saved my life, that is absolutely the truth. One time, the last time, was when I went on my breast cancer journey in 2015 and 16, and I came in here with hair, with no hair, with energy, with no energy. And I needed to be here every week because I walked in that door and everyone saw me as whole and healthy. Marty Dane would come up and hug me, and I'd say, you know, Marty, I was dying. I don't want to hear it. I know who you are. I know that you're wholeness and health. They didn't allow me to go down the rabbit hole. They held me. Sue Mary was my prayer chaplain at the time. They held me in the knowing, and it allowed me to see my own healing for myself. I needed to be here. Every one of Reverend Molly's meditations she did on healing, because our beloved Ed was going through his challenge too. And I felt it every week. We heal each other. The first time Unity saved my life, I never shared this probably with you guys, but I'm going to. I was born in the South, in the deep South, in a very tumultuous relationship my mom and dad had because my mom was diagnosed with schizophrenia. I had one little sister, and it was rough. But when my dad finally left, he found another wife and started to have another family. We were with my mom, and one day my dad went to court. He proved my mom unfit, and he got custody. And one day lawyers showed up at our house, and they took me and my sister to go live with my dad. We weren't really happy about it. We loved our mom. She was definitely wacky, but taught us a lot of wonderful things and was very eccentric and playful, and I got a lot from her. My dad was a doctor, very left brain, very analytical. Got a lot from him too. But on that day, I came home from school, and all my bags were packed, and I ran into my sister's room, and none of her bags were packed. And they had taken her to the dentist, and I ran in the living room, almost hysterical, and said, why are my bags packed? And my dad said, I'm getting rid of you. I'm getting rid of you. Words I'll never forget. There's no hope for you. You are already ruined because of this upbringing. But your sister, I can probably save. I was gone. I didn't say goodbye to my sister. I didn't see her again for 8 years. It was the most devastating thing that had ever happened to me, okay? I began to question God. I was a Southern Baptist girl, even though I was a metaphysician from birth. I didn't get that whole thing, but I was really confused. How could this happen to me? And why was I so bad? Well, first of all, let's just say. But I really went through a period of time where I started seeking God because I didn't have the protection and the love of a divine father. So I found the divine father within me. I became committed to searching within. And wouldn't you know, I get uprooted to California and I walk into a Unity church at age 14. Wah! Unity by the Sea with Dr. Sue Sicking. And she not only mentored me, she found me a therapist. I was headed down a troubled path. I was a troubled youth. And she turned my life around, and she gave me tools to look at every challenge as an opportunity. We are unity. It's in our opportunity is who we are. It was the greatest gift, I've gotten from unity, is to be able to shift that perspective of life and see everything as an opportunity. And listen to the calls that we get inside and pay attention to them. Which leads me to what I was really supposed to talk about. Which was the big leap, the leapfrog. Other people said to me, is this going to be a big leap for you? And I said, no, it's a big leap year. But it's leap year. And I'm reading this book again, The Big Leap, by Gay Hendricks. I don't know if you've read it, but it's really worth reading. And this book, here's a little lesson for today. This book is about stepping in with friendly embracing our zone of genius. It's about hearing the calls within us to and paying attention to them, because if we don't pay attention to them, sometimes they start ringing and alarming so loudly that we get depressed or we get illness or all of these things because we're not paying attention. So when we pay attention to that voice and we start following it, we can move through these zones of activity and lead us to our zone of genius. The first one I'm just going to share with you is called the zone of incompetence. And a lot of us stay there unnecessarily. It's a zone where we don't actually know what we're doing. We don't actually have any talent or gifts in that zone, but we have determined in our ego to figure it out, so we stay there for too long. Then we move into the zone of competence, which is the zone we're actually pretty good at, but other people could do it, but we think we might be faster or quicker, or we have all kinds of reasons why we decide to stay attached to that zone. And we could actually free up a lot of our time to listen to what our zone of genius is if we stepped out of our zone of competence. Does that make sense? So then, if you step into your zone of excellence, which is next, that's what you're really good at, which you probably make a living doing, and what your family and friends identify as you. That's like Rick, who can play any instrument on the planet. That's his zone of excellence. We all have zones of excellence. I think this was my zone of excellence over here, with this hat. But if we stay in that zone of excellence, it's there's a lot of temptation there to not keep moving into our zone of genius. Because that is seductive, that zone of excellence. So I'm just here to remind you, as we know in Unity, what opportunity looks like. When you hear it, when you feel it, don't be afraid to do a leapfrog. All you got to do is breathe, pause, get clarity, and either tiptoe or leap. But make that step. And what leap means, we can put it up there now, is fully rely on God. That's what frog means. So we're going to pause, then we're going to leap, fully relying on God. And when you get to that, when you're fully relying on God, you can make that leap. Okay? That's the leapfrog game. So when you get to your zone of genius, that is what you are all about. That's what your soul is about. That's what your unique design is about. That's what you came here to do. That is the only zone that's going to make you feel fully satisfied, fully alive, and purpose-driven. That is where you want to live. And I am so grateful that you have leapfrogged me into what I believe is my zone of genius now. Really? I really do. Gosh. I heard a lot of nudges, but I didn't pay any attention to them. So I'm really I have a lot of people to be thankful for. And I have to say thank you to Reverend Stacy, because if she hadn't decided to take another job, I would have just been happy in my zone of excellence in my lane, enjoying what I was doing. I always did. So I think that's probably about it. We've gone through just about everything I think I had on here to talk about. When I said to my mentor at Unity Worldwide that becoming a Unity minister was the cherry on my sundae. I said that in my last evaluation. I really meant it. But the truth is, you are the cherry on my sundae every Sunday. And it's just, it is my slice of heaven on earth. This is us. And my job from now on, and I promise to do my best, is to assist you all in shifting into your zone of genius and allowing ourselves to release our version of heaven on earth. And that's what I want to do for you. I hope that's enough. That's it. Thank you.
I hope I didn't talk too long.
You're fantastic.
And now I'm going to sing with the band because I love this song.
Taking my time, gonna slow, oh, 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 I'll take it slow, oh, 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 cause I don't wanna miss this moment, and I can't get it back when it's over. I'm gonna push pause, I'm calling time out, plenty of time, figure it out. I'm gonna push pause, I'm calling time out, time out. I'm gonna push, oh, 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 oh. I'm gonna push. Hope someday I'll look back and say I had it all, oh, 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 I had it all, oh, 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 oh. Less work, more fun, spending more time with the ones I love, saying oh, 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 singing oh, 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 oh. Cause I don't wanna miss this moment, and I can't get it back when it's over. I'm gonna push pause, I'm going time out, plenty of time to figure it out. Gonna push pause, I'm going time out,
time out,
time out. Gonna push, whoa, 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 whoa. Gonna push, oh, 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 oh. Gonna push pause, oh, 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 oh. Gonna push, oh, 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 oh. Gonna push pause, I'm calling time out, plenty of time to figure it out. Gonna push pause, I'm calling time out, time out. I'm gonna push pause, I'm calling time out, plenty of time to figure it out. Gonna push pause, I'm calling time out, calling time out, time out. I'm gonna push, oh, 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 oh. Gonna push, oh, 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 oh. I'm gonna push.
Push pause. Well, I'm here today. I am Lucy, your board member of the day. And
I'm
here is
I'm
our...
With
you're with me? Here is our mission. If you will please read it with me. Unity of the Oaks is a loving, accepting, and heart-centered spiritual community here to be love in action, to encourage personal growth, awaken spiritual curiosity, and transform lives. If you'd like to bless us, we can always use as many blessings as we can possibly have. And Sherry, I definitely believe you are a blessing. So I'm thanking you for stepping in when you did. If you would like to bless us with a love offering, we have several ways for you to give. In the seat in front of you are envelopes for cash or check. Make sure to include your name if you'd like a record of your donations. You'll also find our text to give information. At any time, you can visit our website to give. If you've given electronically, please bless the basket, then pass it along. Now let's take a moment to focus our attention on our giving heart as we feel the abundance of receiving. We visualize the mission statement coming to life. I'm going to set this mic down, so you will be reading this with me and I will be signing it. And please join me in signing, because it's another way to visualize this statement.
Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. I give in love, and I trust God.
We are most grateful for all of your contributions to our community as we grow it with lots of events and classes, which is what Layla is going to speak, but do you realize we have two teenage girls that are helping this church grow in such wonderful ways, too? Both Summer in the back and Layla.
Hello, just a couple quick announcements. March 3rd, our guest speaker will be Reverend Ken Fendrick, and after the service, he will be hosting a Q&A discussion on a love offering basis. And you can sign up for his Walk in Wonder hike in Thousand Oaks, Saturday, March 2nd at 10:30 a.m., which is the day before his guest talk. There is a sign-up sheet in the back of the room. For 2 more weeks, you can still donate wrapped toothbrushes and toothpaste for newly arrived refugee families to the area via the basket in the back. And this information can always be found in the email newsletter we send out each week, so make sure you are signed up. And now, Reverend Sherry, for the induction of this year's Board of Trustees for Unity of the Oaks.
Thank you, baby.
Well, first, I just have to say, Jane Brown, I forgot to mention that you brought that cake for Reverend Stacy's goodbye party. Thank you for doing that. And I wanted to shout out to Candace and Summer for all their help they've been giving me. And Linz, wherever you are, thank you. You guys have been working overtime to help me with this transition. So at this time, I think it is a perfect time to bring those precious folks who have also taken a big leap to step up as your Board of Trustees. We're so grateful you have chosen to share your time, your gifts, your love with all of us. And as Reverend Cynthia called us yesterday, the spiritual goddesses of Unity of the Oaks. Would you come on up, Melba and Lucy and Jules and Nicole? Our dear Lisa decided to stay home today. She's our newest board member, she and Nicole. But she had a cough and she didn't want to give it to anyone. So when you're watching, Lisa, we're thinking of you. And next week we will do a little special induction for Lisa as well. Oh my goodness, I need to get my, Rhonda, can you hand me those two yellow cords right there? Or actually one of them, I just need one for Nicole. Thank you. Having been a previous board member, thank you, Rhonda. Oh, look at these beautiful people.
I want to ask you a few questions, but first, I would like Lucy to put her cord. She's been our president for the last 2 years, and she has decided... Oh, just 1 year, okay. She has decided to pass that torch to Jules. Would you take yours and put it on Jules? And I need one more, Rhonda. Wait, actually, you can do it because you are the vice president. Would you mind putting one on Lucy? Because she is now our new vice president. Thank you, love. And Lisa, our new secretary, we're so grateful that you stepped up to that position. And Melba, hold on. Melba, the awesome treasurer, is going to stay the awesome treasurer. And Nicole. Nicole is our member at large. She was the first one to step up and give me that call that it was on her heart as soon as I took this position. She took this position. So, dear friends, are you prepared to discharge the duties and responsibilities of a board member of Unity of the Oaks, willing to follow the principles and code of ethics as set forth by Unity Worldwide Ministries, and to always look to the Christ within for wisdom, guidance, and inspiration? Do you consecrate yourselves to promoting the welfare and growth of Unity of the Oaks and of the entire Unity movement, to following Unity principles and to looking to Christ within for wisdom, guidance, and inspiration? I hereby install you all as board members of Unity of the Oaks and charge you with the responsibility of serving this church with love, faith, wisdom, and joy. Love, faith, wisdom, and joy. Look at how that worked. We now recognize and acknowledge that myself, the minister, and the new... Ooh, did I hear that? And the new board of directors are here by divine appointment. We commend ourselves as leaders of Unity Oaks to do this spiritual work with the inspiration and guidance of infinite presence. We are open and receptive to the fulfillment of divine order in us and through us and for the unity work as a whole, both here and throughout the world. So now let's join in a blessing. I think it'll be up here in a second. We have a blessing we want to give to our board members. Let's take our hands and warm them up. Ready? Yeah. We love you.
We love you.
We bless you.
You are the face of God. I hold you in my heart. You are a part of me. You are the face of God. You are the face of love. I hold you in my heart. You are my family. You are the face of love.
Yeah.
And that concludes our service. I hope you stay for hospitality. And as Jane told me, it's like I'm the ship that got launched, so I wish we had champagne, but maybe we can go out and have that. Okay. Love you all.
Let's sing our peace song, everybody.
I think Jane already shared that she'll be out there for you as a prayer chaplain.
Here we go.
Yes, there is peace on earth, and yes, it begins with me. Yes, there is peace on earth,
Let's say the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. We are the light. The love of God enfolds us. We are the love. The power of God protects us. We are the power. The presence of God watches over us. We are that presence. Wherever we are, God is. And all is well! Thanks to the Unity Band up here, you guys. We got Tom, Tommy, and John, and I'm Rick.
Woohoo!
That was awesome, you guys. Have a wonderful day.